The next topic we will be seeing is pointers and importance of pointers and why do we need them. If you just want to swap two numbers, like we have given a equal to 10 and b equal to 20, and when we print a and b, we have to get 20 and 10. So I'm trying to build a function called swap function. I input 10 and 20. As they pass by value, functions pass by value, x is copied as 10 and y is copied as 20. So after doing all this stuff, x is 20 and y is 10, but nothing is returned and nothing happens to a and b. So whenever we print, after we print again, we still get 10 and 20 and there is no swap. So to address this issue, we have declared we use the concept called pointers. Pointers are used for storing addresses of declared variables. We declare pointers in a code by type star followed by the pointer name, semicolon. Type star denotes the type of variable it points to. Points also means addresses, has the address, I mean, sorry. This should be the data type to which the pointer points. Type star. Example, int star pointer will have address of an integer, and char star address will have address of a character. And int star star pointer of a pointer will have address of a pointer which stores address of an integer. We have very two important operators in the pointers part. One is the AND, which gives address of a variable. We cannot use AND of a variable, because AND gives us an address and address is not a variable. Star, dereferencing operator. This is called dereferencing operators. It gives us the variable of an address. We can use it multiple times. Suppose we can use star of pointer, which will give us the actual variable. Pointers can only be compared. The other operators cannot be used, like pointer 1 plus pointer 2 and stuff like that. We can only use pointer 1 less than or greater than or equal to. I just gave a diagram to get a overview. This will be a pointer. Star pointer will be the value, and again taking AND will be the address of the value. So we finally get the pointer. We just define a temporary variable to make the swap function. I'm assigning temporary variable as the value at address p1 initially. Then I'm making the address value at p1 is value of p2. Then I'm making the value of p2 as initial value of p1. So here the address of a and b remain same, but the values get interchanged. We can also try this by swapping address. I'm defining a temporary variable p1. I'm assigning address p1 to p2. I'm assigning address of temporary to p2. In this code, the address are just getting exchanged, and a will just have a different address, but the value will be same. So with the values, A is moving to another place and B is moving to another place. But when we call A, it will still be 20, and when we call B, it will still be 20. When we define a pointer or declare a pointer but we don't assign any value, then it has some random rubbish value when we dereference or print it. Suppose we declare an array like array 100 elements. Here array is itself the pointer to the first element. You can also get the same meaning from array would be the address of array square bracket 0, or this could also be another notation which conveys the same meaning. So when we make array 1 is array 2, the address of array 2 is copied to the address of array 1, and both the starting points become same. Incrementing or decrementing a pointer. Suppose this pointer is an integer pointer. In this case, the pointer, incrementing pointer by 1 will move the pointer 4 bytes forward, so the value will increase by 4. Dynamic memory allocation. To use this feature in C programming, we have to use the header file stdlib.h. Used to allocate memory to variables at runtime. This is a very important function. We have to create the variables at runtime and also we have to free them to prevent wastage of space. These newly created variables become lowable variables. You can use them in any functions. Example, you can see here. I am defining a character pointer and assigning the character pointer. The syntax would be type of memory you need and how much byte size. You can also create a contiguous memory using malloc function, which is nothing but creating an array using malloc. You can see the code here. Freeing variables is very important, as I have mentioned before. And common error. Returning the address of a local variable is not allowed. When we try to do this, we'll get a compilation error.